Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to start with chapter 2, subject and predicate. Before starting this chapter, let me first revise what we have done in our previous class. Children, we had done what is a sentence. So as you all know, a group of words which make a complete sense is known as a sentence. And how many types of sentences are there? There are four kinds of sentences, which are declarative, which is also known as assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. So let's discuss on the previous homework assigned to you, exercise 1, which I have given you in your previous class. So number 1, I waited for you at the bus stop. The answer will be assertive or declarative. Number 2. Why did you get late? Question mark. Of course, with a question mark, we'll come to know that it is question being asked over here. So the answer will be interrogative. Number 3. Poppies are my favorite flowers. Answer to which will be assertive or declarative. Question 4. How noisy the place was? With an exclamation mark, we can come to know that it is an exclamatory sentence. Question number 5. Will you finish your homework on time? Question mark. By the question mark, we come to know that this is an interrogative sentence. Number 6. Hush, the baby is sleeping. It is an exclamatory sentence. Though the exclamation is after hush, but still we name is that exclamatory sentence. Number 7. I don't like the people who tell lies. Answer is assertive or declarative statement. Now children, in assertive or declarative statement, there is also negative statement and positive statement. Negative statement is that statement which have don't in the sentence. That is, I don't like the people who tell lies. So, wherever you find the negative statement, this don't will be there or do not will be there. But as it is, as you see in the positive sentence, this don't won't be there. For example, I say, I like the people who tell lies. This will be positive. And I don't like the people who tell lies. It will be negative. Now, students, in this slide, we are going to learn about what is a subject and predicate. In every sentence, that is a complete sentence, we have two parts. Which are those two parts? One is a subject and the other is predicate. So through this diagram, we'll see how sentence is incomplete without a subject and a predicate. So sentence equals to what? Subject plus predicate. Now what is a subject, children? Subject is what we are talking about. That is the who part in the sentence. Okay, and what is a predicate? Predicate is we are talking about the subject, what the subject is doing or what is being said about the subject, that we come to know in predicate. So children, here we see, for example, if I give you, you can see like he is reading. So here, who is the subject? He is the subject. What is he doing? He is reading. So, is reading is the predicate and he is the subject. So, let us see now in subject, we name some person or thing, whereas in predicate, we say about that person or thing. We elaborate that thing. And here we see number one, the part in which we name the person or thing we are speaking about is the subject of the sentence. And in number 2, we see the part which tells about the subject is called the predicate. In this slide, we are going to see or learn more about a sentence, that is how to find a subject and a predicate in a sentence. First of all, we are going to see the subject part, that is the number 1 point is the ask who or what the sentence is about. So the sentence is talking about whom, that is first part. Like you have to ask the sentence itself who or what they are talking about in the sentence. So here in predicate part we'll see we are going to ask what the subject is doing. Now let us clear this with the help of an example. That is, if I say Ram is playing. So Ram is playing. So first we'll ask the sentence who or what the sentence is about. The sentence is about Ram or who, that also Ram. So Ram is the main subject over here, and in order to find the predicate we have to ask what the subject is doing, means what Ram is doing. So what Ram is doing over here? Ram is playing. So is playing will become the subject, that is the doing part. Okay, now let's see the second part of subject, that is how to find a subject. Find the main person. In order to find the subject we have to find the main person. So main person here is Ram. And in predicate part what we are going to see, we are going to see the word that shows action. Which word is showing here any action? Playing. So Ram is playing. So playing is the action. So this is how we come to know that it is a predicate. Now in the third part of the subject we see the subject is usually a noun. Mostly the subject is a noun. A person, place, a thing, or pronoun also we can say over here. That is he, she, it, they, whatever we use for pronouns. So that is the subject actually. And here we see in the third point, coming to the predicate part, we see there are some common words or verbs which end with ing or ed. That is a verb ending ing or ed. Or you can also add ing to a word if it is probably a verb. Like for example, we have already used Ram is playing. So ing is there after the verb. So we can look over there with the common ending, common verb ending, that is ing or ed if it is in the past. Okay, so let us focus on the third part of the subject and third part of the predicate. That is, the subject is usually noun over here, and this side we'll always look for the common verb ending, that is ing, ed, ing, or we can also add ing to a verb. It is probably a verb. Now the fourth part or the last part we can see of the subject is, the subject is usually at the beginning of a sentence before the verb, and it is always placed before the verb, and it is at the beginning, it put at the beginning of the sentence. Now usually is mentioned over here, that means that it is not necessary always that always the subject needs to be in front, so or in the beginning of the sentence. So usually is also mentioned. The verb usually comes after the subject, and most probably what happens, verb is always behind the subject. Subject will be first and then the verb. So we can identify by these all points which we have written under the subject part and which we have written under the predicate part. So we have to look into while we conclude with the subject and predicate part. With this it will become more easy for us to understand how to find out a subject and a predicate. Let us make the concept more clear by looking at some of the examples over here. Number one, we see the kites are flying in the sky. So first we are going to ask the sentence who or what the sentence is about. So it is about the kites, or who they are talking about? The kites. The subject is the kites. And are flying in the sky, here we can see that the subject is always followed by the verb. So the verb also we can find it over here, that will be in the ing form. That is, they are talking about the kites. What they are doing? Are flying in the sky. So flying will become the verb over here. I will underline and write it predicate. So look how it has become so easy when we ask question to the sentence itself. That is in number 2 also we are going to see Ram is eating an ice cream. So first we are going to ask who? So Ram. So Ram will become the subject. What is he doing? That comes in the predicate part. So ing form will also be there. Keeping into mind, we see that eating is there and eating is a verb. Eating is a verb. So is eating what? An ice cream. So this part full will become predicate. So here also we see that the subject Ram also plays the role of a noun. In the third part also, Akbar was a great emperor. Same here, the name of a person, and which also plays the role of a noun. It is also called the subject because when we ask from the question itself who they are talking about, Akbar. So Akbar is the main subject and was a great emperor. Here of course the verb is not given, but remember helping verb is there, that is was. So was a great emperor becomes predicate. They are talking about Akbar. So the main subject Akbar, what they are talking about Akbar, was a great emperor. So now children, in all the 3 examples we saw that the subject here came first, right? But it is not always necessary. And how it is not necessary, how the other sentences look like, let us just have a look with the help of these examples over here. In number 1 we see here comes the bus. Here comes the bus means we are talking about any bus. Who they are talking about or what the sentence is about? The bus. So the bus will be the subject. And what they are talking about is the here comes means now it has come. See, so here comes will become the predicate. Here we are going to see sweet are the uses of adversity. Here they are talking about adversity. So adversity will become the subject. And what is the predicate? What they are saying more about adversity, that their uses are very sweet. Sweet are the uses of adversity. So this is how we separate subject from the predicate or predicate from the subject. In this slide we note that in imperative sentence children the subject is left out. How it is left out, that we are going to see now. But first of all let us discuss on what is imperative sentence. Imperative sentence are those sentence which give commands or requests, that which we have learnt in our previous lesson. In number 1 we see a command is given, that is sit down. So sit down. Here the subject is very well understood by us, that is it is you, but it is not mentioned over here. That we have to understand that you is the subject over here. In the second part also we see the same thing, that is thank him. So the subject will be you thank him. So you will be the main subject over here and rest will become the predicate. And number 3 we see come here. Come here, you come here. Of course when we call someone by our gestures, that come here, that doesn't mean that only come here we are saying, but here you is silent. We have to find out, we have to understand that part. So you come here, so you will become the subject over here. Students, as we completely have an idea about the answers to this exercise, we will again discuss in our next class. What a subject and a predicate is. So let us solve the exercises related to that. In the first exercise in grammar 1, which is given in page number 10, we will see in the following sentence separate the subject and the predicate. So we have to separate the subject and the predicate. So we can also use S for the subject and P for the predicate. So number one is the cackling of geese saved Rome. So who? The cackling of geese will become subject. And what it did? It saved Rome. So it will become predicate. Number two, the boy stood on the burning deck. Who? The boy. So the subject will be the boy. That will become the subject and stood on the burning deck. What he did? He stood on the burning deck will become predicate. Now number three, Tubal Cain was a man of might. Now of course Tubal Cain is the name of somebody, that is a noun, which will also be called as subject, and predicate will be was a man of might. They are talking about Tubal Cain, so it will become the predicate part. Okay, here number four, stone walls do not make a prison. So what they are talking about? They are talking about stone walls. So the subject will be the stone walls. And what they are talking about the stone walls? Do not make a prison. That will become a predicate. Number five, the singing of the birds delight us. What is the subject over here? The singing of the birds. What did it do? It delighted us. So it delights us will become predicate. Children, here is homework assigned to you. That is, you have to do all the rest which are left from number 6 till number 15. And then you have to copy down what is a subject and a predicate. And their usage, how we can understand where to use them and how we can come to difference or distinguish between both of them. So with that, with the help of a column, as I have shown you in the slide, you have to make how to find out a subject and how to find out a predicate, that you have to draw and write down in your copy.